Just as a refresher, let's recall the basic elements of computational photography. But first, let's imagine what is our scenario. We want to take a picture of a 3D scene as demonstrated here, and what we want to convert into is a picture. So in essence, what we have done is we've taken the rays of light that are illuminating the scene and converted it into a two-dimensional picture. Now recall that the main aspects of the computational photography started with illuminating the scene, the optics that were used to then take the light information and get it onto a sensor, which was then converted into an image, and then we can do various types of image processing on it that would be displayed into a picture like this. As you may remember, our goal was to computationalize each and every aspect of this pipeline. Today, of course, in this lesson, what I'm interested in is having you start thinking about how the digital information of the sensor can be actually used to generate a representation that we can actually do various types of image processing on, so then we can display an image. So the three main aspects that we're interested in here is how the digital information from the sensor is put on to generate an image that we can do various types of processing on it to generate a picture. We will discuss more aspects of how a sensor does generate this kind of a signal in a later lecture. Today, the goal is for us to start thinking about how we can actually start doing image processing and computer vision types of techniques on images. So the goal that we have in this lesson is to be able to make an image a computable entity. That is, we can run various types of computational processes on it and actually allow us to start thinking of what is a digital image and what's a representation of a digital image to convert and create images and pictures that we can use for processing.